Hello everyone, it's Janelle from FlipYourLearning. Today we are going to be talking about desmosomes. We will explain their functions, what they look like, and what proteins they are made of. Basically, desmosomes are protein complexes that bring cells together, connecting their intermediate filaments. That's important. If you have been following this series of videos, we first started talking about tight junctions. They connected actin microfilaments, then adherence junctions. They also connected the actin microfilaments. But now it's time for bigger guys, thicker filaments, the intermediate filaments. And this is important because of all the filaments in the cytoskeleton, like actin microfilaments, intermediate filaments, which are made of other proteins like keratin or pigmentin, depending on the cell type, and microtubules made of tubulin, the intermediate filaments, the ones that desmosomes connect, are the strongest ones. Other filaments would break under the tension that intermediate filaments are able to resist. And that's why not only do they connect cells to one another, they are also the best filaments, and desmosomes are the best intercellular junction for resisting forces in the tissue. The reason why when you pull on your skin it doesn't fall off is because of desmosomes. So that's what they do. How do you make one desmosome? If you've seen the previous videos, you know how this goes. This is a membrane, and to make that membrane be connected to a neighboring membrane, we need transmembrane proteins. The ones in desmosomes are desmoglein and desmocolin. And we have already mentioned them in a previous video, when we talked about adherence junctions. Cadherins were one of the kinds of transmembrane proteins in adherence junctions, the other one being nectins. Remember, cadherins grab other cadherins, they make homotypical bindings with them, with identical cadherins, and that is enough to bring cells close together. Not as close as with cladins or occludins, but it's enough to prevent them from separating, especially where you have hundreds or thousands of them in the same area as you do in desmosomes. As we said, these cadherins interact with intermediate filaments, which I'm going to abbreviate as IFs, okay? These can be keratins, pigmentins, or other kinds of fibrillar proteins depending on the cell type. But they don't do it directly, as you're probably used to by now. They need adaptors. The adaptors in desmosomes are three. We have plakophilin and plakoglobin interacting with the cadherin, but not able to interact with intermediate filaments. And we have desmoplakin, which can interact with both this complex of cadherins and the other plakophilin, plakoglobin, and it can also interact with intermediate filaments, bringing all of those things together. By the way, don't mix up all those three desmo things. Desmoglein and desmocolin are cross-membrane proteins, cadherins, and desmoplakin is an adaptor between cadherins and intermediate filaments. Also, one last detail, plakoglobin is also called gamma catenin. Do you remember catenins from when we talked about them in adherence junctions? They were one of the adaptors for the cadherins. We see the same with the cadherins in desmosomes. They need catenins. But to keep this same nomenclature of all the adaptors, having the plakin thing in their name, desmoplakin, plakoglobin, plakophilin, I prefer to call them plakoglobin. It helps me remember what each of them is doing and which ones are just transmembrane proteins and which ones are adaptors. All the adaptors have this plako thing or plake thing in their name. And with that we have a desmosome, because desmocolin uses the same proteins as desmoglein did. It's the same thing, so I'm not even going to write the names for them. When you look at this through a microscope, you will see two areas of denser stuff with more protein and a bit of separation in between, and that corresponds to the denser areas of plakophilin and plakoglobin and the side of desmoplakin that connects to intermediate filaments. That's why you also see desmosomes drawn like this, with two plaques, and they would be made of hundreds and hundreds of these proteins. By the way, if for some reason your body can't make desmosomes or they are destroyed by the immune system, you're in serious trouble because your skin would fall off And that's something that happens. The disease is called pemphigus, and if you're studying this in the context of medicine, you're probably going to hear about it more than maybe if you are just doing the cell biology part. And that's it. This is one slide that summarizes everything. You can download these slides and the rest of them in the channel's website, flipyourlearning.com. If you want to remember this stuff and memorize it, I would suggest using Anki and the image occlusion add-on to cover up the names of the things you want to remember or entire definitions if you want. And having it test yourself. I've already talked about it in other videos, and I will make more videos about it in the future. With that said, I hope you enjoyed this. The next video is going to be about hemidesmosomes, which are not so much like desmosomes. Yes, they also connect the intermediate filaments of cells to other stuff, but it's not even to other cells, it's to the basal lamina. And it doesn't use cadherins, it uses integrins and different adaptors, so yeah. Alright, I'll see you soon. Adiós.